Brenda's having a baby out of wedlock, not ready to get married. She supports the LGBTQ community, not a Christian. Easy. Bethany, Kristen, Morgan, etc. I think you say that so easily of me because you identify Christians by their sexuality and perhaps their sexuality alone. Hi beautiful people! So I'll link all the relevant videos below, but in short, there's been some drama between Girl Defined and God is Gray. After asking Kristen and Bethany for a one-on-one conversation, they questioned my faith at a conference.
And on this channel, I still to this day, I don't know, like, why call yourself a Christian?
After the Girl Defined conference, I put out a video expressing my feelings on this. In response, people from both of our communities pled for them to apologize and have a conversation with me. So this Wednesday, they made a video response. The key here is the title, Talking About God is Gray. They did send me a nice apology and informed me they would be releasing a response video. I thanked them and once more expressed my desire for a conversation, but instead, apparently, the choice remains to talk about and not to me. For God is Gray, I've reached out to many people I disagree with for conversation, including Girl Defined, Ali B. Stuckey, Paul and Morgan, Mr. Atheist, and Dr. Julie Slattery. Mr. Atheist and Dr. Julie Slattery said yes. They were open. These conversations led to 0% change in either of our fundamental beliefs.
Hi, beautiful people.
But both conversations ended in beautiful friendship. I respect, love, and root for both of these friends, and they feel the same way about me. All the others hesitate or outright refuse to talk to me because we don't see eye to eye on doctrine. Or in Morgan's case, she refuses to even kindly speak to people that she doesn't agree with.
We will probably not ever have back and forth with Brenda.
And you know what? We're called to love everyone, but you don't have to like them. And I do not like Morgan. I find her condemning, condescending, patronizing, and hard-headed.
Yeah.
Qualities I'm really not into. I'll be putting out a video on my feelings about that. Not this, but next Monday. So stay tuned. Again, because we're gonna continue to talk about one another and not to each other, which I really wish we would, here goes another video. First things first, hundreds, if not thousands of people demanded Girl Defined apologize to me, whether by direct comment or by liking a comment. And I love you guys for that. But an apology is actually not something I ever asked for or even wanted. What I wanted was an open dialogue. What I wanted was to show both of our communities how Christians can lovingly disagree. I do appreciate the kindness in which Kristen and Bethany addressed me in this video.
We don't dislike Brenda. Honestly, looking back, there are some things that we would do differently.
But it was not a response. They ignored many, if not all of the points I brought up in the prior video. So let's make this quick. Three things that remain unaddressed. Number one, I am not hurt, offended, or even put off by the fact that they publicly disagree with me. I don't even care that they used my video at the conference. I was hurt because of this.
Like, why even call yourself a Christian?
Bethany, Kristen, you said you did this because we have a biblical right to call out false teachers.
When Jesus engaged with religious hypocrites and false teachers, he responded with righteous fury and bold conviction.
But you're not seeing the irony of this, which is that you encourage young women to open up their Bibles, to look, to research, to pore over it, to not even listen to you or any other outside influences and get the truth for themselves.
We want you to go back to God's word, go back to the Bible, examine the scriptures, search the scriptures, and see if what we're saying is truly biblical.
But when someone does exactly that, someone like me, you call them false teacher. Which leads me to believe that you only encourage women to dive in and to research and to understand the Bible as long as that research leads them exactly to what you believe. And if they don't, they'll risk being called a false teacher by you or ask the most offensive question that a Christian can ask another Christian, which is this.
Like, why even call yourself a Christian?
I know that she claims to be walking with the Lord, but I would question that.
Which brings me to number two. Bethany doubled down on her original point that she made at the conference, which is that my journey from being taught LGBTQ was a sin into affirmation was a decision I made solely based on my feelings.
The point we were trying to make is the dangers of basing truth on feelings or on an experience with the Holy Spirit.
Bethany, did you not watch my video response? To save myself the time and energy, I will play that clip again. This entire video is about about an encounter I had with the Holy Spirit after researching and delving into this issue for 15 years. What Bethany is failing to mention or see is that I do not present these subjects to you guys carelessly. There is an array of books, Bible-based books, by Christians, by theologians, and many of them are concluding exactly what I did. The reason this is so triggering is because, are we allowed to study the Bible or not? Is everyone that doesn't see theology your way lying about their relationship with Christ? I'm not going to explain a trillion times to someone who is determined not to listen the extent of my biblical research, which brings me to the last ignored point. Number three, the main thing Girl Defines, Paula Morgan, Ali B. Stuckey, etc. are taking for granted when they talk about me is this. Everything you know about the Bible was passed down to you by your particular leadership in your particular circle. Unless you want to tell me you spent 5 years in the Himalayan mountains with Franciscan monks debating theology, in which case, I stand corrected. When you say the Bible is so clear, you are wrong. It is perhaps the single most debated, studied, and complicated text in human history. Even the decision of which books would be included in the Bible you're reading today, which could be one of 30 English translations, came from the leadership of the Catholic Church. When Protestants emerged, books were taken out of that original Bible. Jewish scholars, Franciscan monks, and the Christians that I choose to keep in my personal circle are those who honor the tradition, the nuance, the complication, the contradiction, and the mystery of the Bible. In conclusion, Bethany, Kristen, Morgan, etc., I would never have the audacity to question whether or not you're Christians. I will warn people when you're saying something harmful, but I will not tell them you are not a Christian. I think you say that so easily of me because you identify Christians by their sexuality and perhaps their sexuality alone. Brenda's having a baby out of wedlock, not ready to get married. She supports the LGBTQ community, not a Christian. Easy. And you'll say, it's not about that. It's my lack of repentance. And I'll say, I've dove into all the theology and I've studied it forever and I'm making my own personal choices and I have conviction from God that I am okay. And you will say, not a Christian. Meanwhile, I identify Christians by those of us who are constantly seeking God, who profess the name of Jesus. And again, I'll link my resources below, but historically, Christians I know that are in this mindset will say, I'm not reading those, the Bible is my only authority.
We will always seek and strive to go back to God's word as our only and complete source of truth.
But Bethany has already contradicted that by not only writing her own books, but by also recommending supplementary material.
We're actually going to link to some articles and some podcasts below about how to build your life on the Word of God.
For anyone who's genuinely interested in understanding where I'm coming from, these are Bible-based resources, books that rocked my world, that brought me closer to God, that brought me more peace on the subjects that bring so much pain and discord into the Christian community. All of us Christians keep saying, look at the fruit.
Jesus was questioning what they believed, questioning their theology based on their actions, based on the fruit that was coming out of their lives.
Evangelical church planted trees of anti-LGBTQ doctrine, and the fruit is rotten. It's been rotten for decades and continues to rot. I've got nothing else to say except that all of this has been disappointing. I have no intention of residing in this drama. I will continue making content that I believe in from the bottom of my heart. I will continue imparting those messages with a lot of care and research. I will continue to remain open-minded for when I get things wrong. I will continue to be a safe space for you to tell me your secrets, to ask me your questions, and I will continue to affirm LGBTQ Christians. And that's it. Please like, subscribe, share with your friends, donate to my Patreon or Venmo if you can. I love you guys. God bless.